If you're using Mac hardware with an unsupported macOS like Catalina, Big Sur or Monterey, some components cause trouble and don't work out of the box, like Wi-Fi, Ethernet, USB, brightness control or sound. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fix that. And in the second part, I'm going to show you how to upgrade the Mac Pro's Wi-Fi Bluetooth module to a brand new one with 5 GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 4.0 to enable, for instance, sidecar and all the new fancy stuff. So let's start. I still got my old Wi-Fi card in my Mac Pro, and you installed Big Sur, no Wi-Fi. And if you go to the system preferences to network, you're going to see no Wi-Fi option like I already have here. I just tried the Wi-Fi driver. It works. So you see it up front. But you won't have this option as Apple dropped driver support for the old Wi-Fi card after Mojave. I give you the link down in the video description. If you download my open core Mac Pro package zip file, it's a 55 megabyte zip file that I also used for my tutorial how to install macOS Big Sur on unsupported devices with open core with a bootloader. And you just do a double click on the zip file and you get the folder. You go into the folder. Let me just clean this up a little bit. And you see three different folders. And we need the folder patched texts. If you go in here, let me just enlarge this a little bit. You find the script that installs the driver and the text files, which are the driver files. Okay. And all we have to do, as the script is programmed this way, you need any kind of USB drive, whichever size. This is just a small one. 4 GB I just insert here. And we just highlight those two files, do a right click or a control click, and we say copy. And then we go to the USB drive and we say paste two items. All right. And then one more important step, we have to rename that USB drive. Do a right click or a control click here onto the name and say rename USB. And we have to call it install space macOS space big space sur, so that the script thinks we are installing from a prepared install drive that the patcher normally creates, but we just skip all the work and the time to create that. We just copy it here. Okay. Now we need to go into the terminal. So we do the launchpad and then we go to other terminal. Okay. Let me just enlarge this also that you can read what I'm typing here. And first, when I open the terminal, I type ls to see where am I. Okay. So these are my folders, but we now need to go back to the root of the Mac and then into the volumes. So we see the USB drive. So to go back, you just type CD for change directory, do a space and two dots. Do another LS. Okay. That's one layer above. Do another CD space dot dot and do an LS. And now we're in the root of the Mac. So now you see there is the directory volumes. Okay. So we now do CD volumes, do another LS, and then we see my hard drives here and the USB drive we just renamed. So to get into that USB drive, it's a little bit tricky because every time there's a space in the naming, like after install, after macOS and after big, the CD command thinks you're typing arguments to that command, but we just have one name. So we do CD install, and then we need a backslash and a space. So now CD knows this is just a space in the naming of the volume or in of the directory. So macOS, and it doesn't matter if you type capital letters or not, big, sir. So that's how it should look like. Type enter and ls, and you see we're now on the USB drive. And there you see our script, patchkex.sh. And to run the script, you have to type ./ patchkex.sh, because otherwise macOS tries to get into a folder or whatever, so it doesn't know what to do. Oh, I forgot an S. So if you just want to recall the last command, just push the arrow up and it just recalls all the last commands. You see with arrow up and down, you can cycle through them. Go here, type an S, and there we go. So because this needs administrator rights, you have to type in your login password. So if I hit now return, it says, okay, no Wi-Fi option. And it's checking for 802.11.ac. That's a 5 GHz, but it's not installed yet. So it just detected my model MacPro 5.1, and it's using the 2012 patch mode. Okay, so it does some fancy stuff with mounting and unmounting. And you see it's beginning the patched kext IO8211 family kext installation. That is the old kext driver for this kind of Wi-Fi cards. The script calls it Mojave Hybrid Wi-Fi Patch, okay? So you see it's installed the patched kext successfully. Now you do a restart with your Mac, and then if you go to the system preferences and to network, the option Wi-Fi should be available. So one more thing, if you did the restart, you have the Wi-Fi option, you turned it on and you don't find any networks. You see here, there are a lot of networks that the Wi-Fi finds. Just do join other network and then you say show networks, okay? And then the list of Wi-Fi networks should be populated. If nothing shows up here, even not your own Wi-Fi network, it helps. Sometimes you have that kind of problems. It helps if you click onto the Apple and you click about this Mac and you say system report, where we've been in the beginning. And you now go to Wi-Fi. And you see here, you see the software versions and the airport extreme, Broadcom, whatever, the airport chipset. And then you see current network information, and then all networks that are in range should be populated here. So you see my Jessies, you see some other networks and all those networks that are available. And normally, if this list here has been populated, maybe you need another restart, but then this option here, Wi-Fi, when you go to join other network and you say show networks, then this list should get populated as well. And then you can choose your Wi-Fi network and connect to that.